Hi guys, this is Juby Tips, where you will learn about Excel, PowerPoint, Word, productivity tips. So today I'm going to explain to you how to connect your Word mail merges with hyperlinks. In other words, you want the link to change dynamically based on which mail merge item you have connected to your document. Now, this is not going to explain about how to connect your Word document with mail merge, for example, CSV file or Excel files. You have to do that yourself. But the moment you have it connected, if you go to Insert Merge Field, you should see a list of stuff in here. So I'm not gonna explain about that. So that's gonna connect about how to do it with a hyperlink. So here I have this, get a survey from the customer kind of a thing. I want the customer to click the link behind these 5 stars. Okay. So I'm gonna get started. First, I'm gonna have to click Enter here to enter a new line. We're not going to touch the star just yet. Okay. We're gonna just insert the cursor here. We're gonna go to Insert, Quick Parts, and then we are going to go to Field, and then under here type H to go to Hyperlink, and then click OK. Now this is gonna show up as some weird error, hyperlinks reference is not valid. That is fine. You click somewhere in the middle of it, press Alt F9 on your computer, Alt F9, you're gonna see the code. By the way, click Alt F9 again to hide it. Okay, you can toggle it off and on, and we see this hyperlink something like merge format. We're gonna position our cursor right after the hyperlink and the space right here. We're going to go to mail link, insert merge field, and you just pick the link that comes from your merge field data. So I'm just gonna grab this one right here, and it has this thing. I'm gonna just insert one space here. Okay. So by the way, this, you might think this is the end, but this is not the end, because if you save your document now, when you refresh it, then Word will convert your link into a static link, not a dynamic, a merge field connected link anymore. So to fix that, you're gonna place your cursor right after the space here. You're going to go to insert, and then choose bookmark under this links area, okay? And you're gonna just type some stuff. I already have a link here, just gonna make a new one here. So I'm gonna call it link, add it, and I'm going to save the file. And you can press F9 again, okay? And I'm now gonna close the file just to see that how it's gonna show up later. Okay, I reopened the file. It asked me if I want to connect to my data source. I click okay, and then the data is here. Now how I'm going to test, I'm gonna go to mail links. I'm gonna make sure the preview results is on, and I'm gonna, for example, just choose an entry, like entry number 3. Okay, click enter. I hover my mouse here. I should see some data, okay? And for example, it says some number here. Like for example, you see the name of the person is something like hidden row. Let's go to data 4. So now the name is D-U-N-G. If we go to number 5, the name becomes something else. Let's see, number 7 maybe. Yeah, the name changes, you see. So this is working correctly. Now the last step, after you get it to be corrected, is you need to copy these guys here, okay? Now I'm gonna go over here, and I'm just gonna paste him right in the middle. Alright, and I'm gonna delete, you can just Control V, okay? And I'm gonna delete the rest of this stuff with your keyboard, okay? Excuse me, I'm gonna go here, and hit delete. And yeah, that should work. That should, you know, still work as you cycle through the entries. The name still changed, and now you can remove these other things, okay? So that's it, that's how it works. Remember to add your bookmark in the end. If you don't add your bookmark, this will not work after you update your document. Save and open your document again. So that's it. Remember to subscribe if you want to learn more about Word, Excel, PowerPoint tips to improve your productivity. Thanks for watching, and see you soon. Bye bye.